Hey, Harry Potter fans! Peter Kenneth here. Welcome back to the Potter Collector Channel, where we are a community of collectors. Holy moly cannoli, am I excited about this unboxing right here. After this one, we will have unboxed all three of the broomsticks. Inside this box is the Noble Collection Nimbus 2001 replica, and it was a gift from Draco's father. All right, let's open this thing up. Now, this broomstick, I've seen in person, and it is stunning. I don't think I've ever held one, though, so I'm excited to see how it feels, how heavy it is. Let's get all the components out. Just like the Firebolt, it comes with a hook, so you can hang it on your wall. And if you are new to the Potter Collector Channel, welcome. We're happy to have you here. All right, this is really, really well packed. Styrofoam everywhere, cushion everywhere. So if you order this for your collection, know that it's going to arrive safely. I see the foot pedals. Looks like this piece is coming out first. Now, if you're a Harry Potter fan or a Harry Potter collector, you've heard of the Noble Collection. They are literally the premier brand when it comes to replicas from the movies. And here is the Nimbus 2001 broom. So the bristles as well as the foot pedals. Let's put this aside while we get the broom handle out. All right, here is the broom handle. I'm going to move this box out of the way. Wingardium Leviosa. I love magic. Time to unwrap what should be a very shiny black handle. Oh my goodness. Hello, beautiful. Look at that high gloss, that beautiful shine. Look at the Nimbus 2001 logo. Here's a detail I didn't know that this broomstick had. Look at the design element on this handle. You would kind of imagine that this would be a solid piece, but it's cut in half, and then there's like a little support section underneath it, which I really like. So it gives it a very aerodynamic appearance. I'm totally making up this broomstick aerodynamic stuff, but the air would flow under here and disperse, giving the broomstick more speed. I don't know, but I like that design element a lot. Assembly is required. There's a little hole in here, and then, oh yeah, and then there's a screw hole under here. Oh, we haven't even looked at this in detail yet. Hold on, before we assemble it, let's take a look at the base of the broom. Now, the one thing that I've always disliked about the Nimbus 2001 is this solid plastic broom bristle section. We've seen other companies put out real wood bristles, and even the Firebolt, although they're plastic, has individual bristles from the Noble Collection. So this just feels like an easy solution when it comes to this broomstick, but it still looks beautiful. And as far as I know, the broomsticks that were used in the movie were made out of plastic because they do appear very tight and formed in Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, the movie. But check out the detail here. So at the end of the broom bristles, there's some wear and tear, which makes this feel more authentic because we see the Quidditch players, you know, holding the broom on the ground. So there would be wear and tear. The broomstick pedals, as well as the wiring that's holding the broomstick together, are all made out of metal. You can have those foot pedals folded down, or they stop right here so you can place the broomstick on a tabletop and display it that way. So that's nice. It's versatile when it comes to displaying the broomstick. The foot pedals rotate all the way around, and it's just a really well-made piece. Even though this is a solid plastic piece, it's a well-made plastic piece. All right, so we have the screw that is going to screw the broom handle into the base. So let's slide the handle into the base there. And there we have it. And then there's a little piece here that you slip inside, and it has a design of the broom bristles, which makes the hole for the screw virtually invisible. So it's super easy to assemble, a lot easier to assemble than the Firebolt. It just required one screw to attach the handle to the base. A very nice broomstick, especially when it's put together. I mean, look at that high gloss black. It looks super sharp. It's lighter than the Noble Collection Firebolt, so for cosplay, this is definitely a better choice. However, I would be concerned using this broom or taking it to conventions because of this plastic piece here. This is probably easily damaged. as it's hollow on the inside and then the paint might get scuffed up. So just be warned if you're thinking about taking this broomstick with you for cosplay purposes, but for display and collecting purposes, this thing looks really nice from far away. I mean, it looks really nice from up close. So again, it comes with a hook that allows you to hang it up, or you can put the kickstand down and display it this way on a tabletop or something. I'm looking at the Firebolt right there. It's hanging up on my wall. So I'm gonna grab it and let's do a quick comparison of the two Noble Collection brooms. So here is the Firebolt. Design-wise, I think this broomstick wins hands down over the Nimbus 2001. Although for a lot of people, they like a more simplistic design, and I usually am one of those people, but there's something about the Firebolt that's just stunning when it comes to the metal and the bristles, that handle there with the detailed writing on it, the smooth and rough side of the handle. It's just a fantastic, beautiful broom. The two of them side by side though, that's pretty awesome. So I guess the last test is to see how easy it is to mount. It's pretty easy. What do you guys think of the Nimbus 2001? Is this something that you've purchased or something that you would purchase for your collection? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. And in the description down below, there is a link to show you where you can find the Nimbus 2001 to add to your collection. A big thank you to the Noble Collection.
How dare you, Avada!
I mean, Draco's father, for sending this broomstick. It was well worth having to put up with Draco Malfoy as the Seeker to have everyone on the Slytherin Quidditch team riding one of these bad boys. If you have any questions about Harry Potter or collecting, feel free to leave a comment down below. You can also join the Potter Collector community on Instagram at the Potter Collector or on Twitter at Potter Collector. Now it's time to like, comment, subscribe, and until next time, keep collecting. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new here, welcome. You can subscribe right up here. You can also look at some previously posted content down here. If you have any questions about Harry Potter books or collecting, please feel free to contact me. I'm always happy to help. But for now, I must go. See you next time.
Whoa, where'd he go?